He's got intel about an imminent attack on U.S. soil.
We don't dictate law to the Iraqis anymore.
Execute him now, and everything he knows is gone forever.
Your family was in hiding, afraid for their lives. Lives.
Last night, at 2300, two UH-60 Black Hawk gunships lit the target with over 8,000 rounds. During the sweep, one of the Deltas found something else. Marine Sergeant Nicholas Brody, MIA since early 2003 and presumed dead. Until now.
Welcome home.
Look how beautiful you are.
The Vice President.
Sergeant Brody, it's an honor.
Thank you, sir.
What were his exact words?
An American prisoner of war has been turned.
As you know, the first 72 hours after soldiers' capture are critical. Sergeant Brody stopped being a source of actionable intelligence, and yet he was still kept alive.
You know what I really need? The last 8 years back, where I get to take care of my wife and kids. And I'm not sent over there to fight their fucking war.
If Brody had really been turned, he'd be talking to the press outside his house, playing the hero card.
You're suggesting that Abinazir planted intelligence on his own safe house just so we could recover Sergeant Brody.
Do you know who this man is?
No, I never met him.
If he is a terrorist, we need eyes and ears on Brody from the minute he steps off that plane.
Out of the question. You think for 1 minute you get away with this?
I thought that once I had some proof.
Yeah, but you've been suggesting that Sergeant Brody's what you think he is.
What'd I tell you when I agreed to give her one more chance? I said it would end badly for both of you.
Just tell me I'm not out here risking federal prison on behalf of a crazy person.
What are you saying? That I'm making this shit up? If somebody's trying to make contact with Brody, it'll only happen once.
The brass sent you over here to turn me into some poster boy for their war. The days that I take orders from the United States military are over.
Gary,
I need you to promise.
You will raise no eyebrows in there.
There are times when you have to stand up for yourself and what you believe in.
I'm just making sure we don't get hit again.
On behalf of the President of the United States, it is my privilege to welcome you home.